Hi, in this video we'll be taking a look at expanding single brackets. So this is aimed around GCSE 9-1 for the foundation tier, but the later questions, so where it says level 5, it may be appropriate for the higher tier students as well. But for level 3, level 4, it's predominantly for the foundation tier, but it's also appropriate for Key Stage 3 maths and even Key Stage 2 maths. Okay, so anyone in year 6, 7, 8, 9, or even year 10, it also will be appropriate for. This is question number one, okay, part A. Expand the following two brackets E minus 8. Well, everything on the inside of the bracket is being times by the number on the outside of the bracket. So I do 2 times E, which is 2E. So 2E, and then 2 times negative 8 is negative 16. Okay, so my answer is just 2e minus 16, or minus 16 plus 2e. Okay, so it should be a 2 there, guys. Okay. Okay, so 2e minus 16. 2 times e is 2e, and then 2 times negative 8 is negative 16. Part B, 4 brackets c minus 6. Well, 4 times c is 4c. Okay, let's just do that again. So 4 times c is 4c. Okay, I think it's been a bit laggy, guys, so I do apologise about this. And then 4 times negative 6 is negative 24, okay? Because a positive times a negative is a negative, okay? So 4 times C is 4C, and then 4 times negative 6 is negative 24. This is part C. Expand this single bracket. Well, 4 times D is 4D. Okay, so 4D. And then 4 times positive 7 is positive 28. Okay, this is part D. Expand this single bracket. Well, 6 times T is equal to 6T. Okay, so it should be a T there. And then 6 times positive 7 is positive 42. Okay. So that's the answer for that one. For part E, 2 times 3p is 6p, so it's 6p there. 2 times negative 8 is minus 16. Okay, so the answer for part E is 6p minus 16. Okay, so 6p minus 16. This is question number 2. Expand the following. So 2p brackets p minus 9. Well, 2p times p, okay, is 2p squared. Okay, because p times p is p squared, or p to the power of 2. So if I'm ever multiplying a letter by itself, then it's that letter to that power, okay? 2p times negative 9 is minus 18p. Okay, so that's my answer for question 2a. Okay, for 2b, 6a brackets a plus 4. Well, 6a times a is 6a squared. Okay, so it's 6a squared. Okay, and then 6 times positive 4 is plus 24a. Okay, because 6 times 4 is 24, and then just put the a after. So it's just 24a. Okay, this is part C. 5h times 3h is 15h squared. Okay. 5h times minus 2 is minus 10h. Okay. This is part D. 2e times 2e is 4e squared. Two e times positive 9 is positive 18e. Okay, so remember, everything inside my bracket is being multiplied by the number and or term on the outside. Okay, for part E, 2p times 5p is 10p squared, because 2 times 5 is 10, and then p times p is p squared. And then 2p times negative 4 is minus 8p. Okay, so hopefully it's making sense so far, guys. Okay, so everything inside the bracket is being multiplied by the number or term on the outside of my bracket. Okay, this is question number 3a. Which of the following is the expanded form of 5 brackets 3a minus 8? Well, 5 times 3a is 15a. Okay, and then 5 times negative 8 is negative 40. Okay, so 5 times negative 8 is negative 40. Okay, so I'm going to circle option number 3. This is part B. So which of the following is the expanded form of this bracket? Well, 5x times 3x is 15x squared. Okay, so that straight away rules out 2, 3, and 4. So I know that my answer is going to have to be the first one, but we can just check by following it through. 15x squared. Should be a 2 there, guys, sorry. Okay, and then 5x times plus 10y is plus 50xy. Okay, because 5 times 10 is 50, x times y is just xy. Should be an x there, and then a y, okay? So we're going to circle option number 1 for part B. Should be an x, x there, guys. I've done that again. It should be an x there, okay? So 15x squared plus 50xy, guys, for part B. For part C, which of the following is the expanded form of this? Well, a10 times 3n squared is equal to 24n cubed. Okay. So straight away, that's going to rule out 2. And it could be this one, but again, we've got to double check. And then 8n times positive 3n is plus 24n squared. Okay, so it can't be option 1 either, because it's got another term as well after the n cubed. So the answer is going to be option number 4. Okay. This is part D. Which of the following is the expanded form of this? XY times X is X squared Y, and then XY times positive 4 is 4XY. So my answer is option number 2. So XY times X is X squared Y, and then XY times positive 4 is positive 4XY. Okay, this is part 4a. Which of the following is the expanded form of this? Well, expanding my bracket, I'm going to have m times m, which is m squared. m times positive 5, which is plus 5n. Or 5m, sorry, not 5n. Okay, plus m times m, which is m squared. And then m times positive 7 is plus 7m. Okay, m squared plus m squared is 2m squared. 5m plus 7m is 12m. So I'm going to circle option number 3. Okay, so collecting my like terms, m squared plus m squared is 2m squared, 5m plus 7m is 12m. Okay, this is part B. Which of the following is the expanded form of this? A times t is at. Okay, a times 4 is positive 4a. And then minus a times 4 is minus 4a. And then I'm going to have plus 3AT. Okay, so plus 3AT. Because minus A times minus 3T becomes a positive. Minus and a minus times together make a plus. Okay, collecting like terms now. Well, 4A minus 4A is going to be 0. Okay, I've got 180 plus 3AT. It's going to be 480. So it's option number 4. So the answer is 480. Part C. Okay, so which of the following is the expanded form of this? Well, 4 times 7 is 28. A cubed times A is A to the 4. I'm going to have B. 4 times negative 8 is minus 32. So minus 32 A cubed B squared. So my answer is going to be this one. Okay, because it's A cubed times A is A to the 4. So yeah, and then I'm going to have a B there. Okay, 4 times 7 is 28, and then 4 times minus 8 is minus 32. A cubed times B squared is just A cubed B squared. Okay, part D. Which of the following is the expanded form of this? Well, 4x times 3x is 12x squared. Minus 4x cubed minus 8x squared and then plus 10x cubed. Okay, by expanding that one, okay, 8x squared plus 10x cubed. Okay, so collecting like terms now, 12x squared minus 8x squared is going to be 4x squared. Okay, so that one and that one are going to simplify to 4x squared minus 4x cubed plus 10x cubed. Should be an x there, not a k. Okay, it's going to be plus 6x cubed. Okay, so we're going to circle option number 1. This is 5 part A. Okay, expand and simplify the following expressions. So 5 times 3x is 15x. Okay, 5 times, should be an x there. 5 times negative 7 is minus 35. Plus 3 times x is plus 3x. And then plus 3 times 2 is positive 6. Okay, collecting like terms, guys. Okay, 15x add 3x is 18x. Minus 35 add 6 is minus 29. So the answer is 18x subtract 29. Okay, this is part B. Y times y is 2y squared. Y times positive 3 is 3y minus 2y squared plus 3y, because minus y times negative 3 is positive 3. Okay, so remember that I'm expanding each bracket separately. 2y squared subtract 2y squared goes to 0. 3y and 3y is going to be 6y. Oh, sorry guys. Should be a 6. Okay, so 6y. Okay, so the answer is 6y. Part C. 7x times 8x is 56x squared. Seven x times minus 3 is minus 21x. Minus 2 times x is minus 2x squared. And then it's going to be minus 20x. So 56x squared minus 2x squared is 54x squared. Minus 21x minus 20x is minus 41x. Okay. This is question number 6, guys. Expand and simplify the following expression. So 6xy times 2x is 12x squared y. So 12x squared y. 6xy times minus 4 is minus 24xy. Minus 20x squared y. And then plus 32xy. Okay, because minus 4 times minus 8 is positive 32. So, collecting like terms now, minus 24x squared plus 32, sorry, minus 24xy plus 32xy is 8xy. Okay. It's 12x squared minus 20x squared is minus 8x squared y. Okay, this is question number 7. Mr. Jenkins walks X kilometers to work each day. Mr. Taylor cycles twice as far as Mr. Jenkins and then an additional 5 to get to work. They both return home after making the same journey back. Write an expression in the form for how far Mr. Taylor cycles each day. Okay, so Mr. Jenkins, so I'm just going to put Mr. J, okay, for Jenkins. Okay, so he, now assuming work is Monday to Friday, so Mr. Jenkins walks in a week, okay, 5x. Okay, so it's x plus x plus x plus x plus x. Okay, so that's for the whole week. Okay. Sorry. That's just him going to work each day, and then obviously plus his journey home. Sorry. It's going to be 10x. Okay. Week. Now, Mr. Taylor, he says he cycles twice as far. Okay, so if Mr. Jenkins walks x, then it's going to be x times 2, which is going to be 2x. Okay, so hopefully he's making sense so far. And then it says that he does an additional 5 kilometers more to get to work. So I'm going to add 5 to that. Okay, so that's going to be that's going to be just one journey. Okay, now if I do that again, okay, because you're going to obviously cycle home again, I'm going to add 2x plus 5. Okay, and what am I going to get? Well, I'm going to get 4x plus 10. Okay, when I collect my like terms for the distance that Mr. Taylor travels, 2x plus 2x is 4x, 5 plus 5 is 10. Okay, so 4x plus 10, which I can factorize, so take 2 out as a factor. So I'm going to take 2 out as a factor, and then I'm going to have 2x plus 5. Okay, so it's 2 lots of 2x plus 5. And that's the distance that Mr. Taylor travels each day. Okay, now for Mr. Jenkins, I didn't need to actually work out the whole week, but that's if you're actually interested. So Mr. Jenkins would obviously walk 2x per day, because it's x there and then x back here, so it's x plus x, which is equal to 2x. The 5x came from 5 days a week, okay, and then obviously walks home Monday to Friday, 5 days a week. Okay, so that's where the 10x came from, but I didn't really need to actually work that out actually for that one there. Okay, part B, expand the expression of Mr. Taylor. Well, expanding this, 2 times 2x is 4x, and 2 times positive 5 is positive 10. Okay, which is the answer that we had here when we came to factorize it. Okay, so factorizing is the opposite of expanding. Okay, so what I did on the last part was I factored 4x plus 10 into like a single bracket, because it wanted it in the form of this. So I knew that I was going to have a plus 5 here. So A was equal to 2 and B was equal to 2. Okay, and when I expanded that, I got 4x plus 10, okay, because 2 times 2x is 4x, and 2 times positive 5 is positive 10. Okay, right, guys, so that is the end of today's video. So that is the worksheet, guys, yeah, so that's the PDF link if you wanted to have a go at that. Okay, I sincerely hope that you found it useful. I hope you found it informative. Any questions, any queries, any pointers that you want to ask me, then feel free to put it below in the comment section. Okay, thank you so much for watching, and thank you for making it to the end of the video. Okay, any topic requests, put it in the comments below, okay, or comment on my community tab, okay. But that's it for me today, guys. Thanks for watching, take care, stay safe, and I'll catch you in the next one. Goodbye for now.